My name is Righteousniki, and welcome back to another Overmind game. We're going to be playing on Tumoda Sparkwing. Bans are going to be Phoenix and Garrosh, first pick Hanzo. We're going to get Gul'dan and Ragnaros. Gul'dan and Ragnaros, by the way, excellent. Ragnaros, just excellent on Tomb of the Sparkwing with Molten Core to put pressure, and if you need to defend. And Gul'dan as well, excellent wave clear. Now, I'm going to be checking the profile of this guy, because from what we've walked at this point, it would be nice if this guy can go healer, because I'm playing in this game and I am going to play Taste for Blood Asmodan, and our last pick is planning to go Johanna, which is going to help me stack even better. I did ask them in the chat before everything that I was planning to play Asmodan, so maybe we can work our picks around me a bit. So ban is going to be Diablo, very solid ban on this map, and for their side it's going to be Stukov. Since they walked Morphirion, they're going to remove the other strong support, which is Stukov. So I'm going to go Asmodan, and this guy is actually going to pick Johanna, which is fine. He didn't have a lot of supports. I did tell my team, since I looked into the profile of the Johanna, the abusive chat, that he only had Morphirion and Lilia support, so I asked our last pick to maybe go support, and he will. They're gonna go Malta. Malta is pretty decent versus our team, because we actually don't have a lot of hard CC, and we don't have a lot of mobility, so Malta can get some value here, and a Nubarak for their main tank. We are all magic damage mostly, so Anub is a pretty good choice. I'm gonna go Karazim support. I did ask him to go Blue Quest.
Green or red, not blue.
Blue Quest, but he actually said that he want to go green or red. Now, I don't mind red, it's a more aggressive one, but I never really, because I've played a lot of Karazim, and I always love the Blue Quest because of the cooldown reduction and AoE healing. I've never really liked the Green Quest. But there's some people that can play the Green Karazim quest pretty well, and I'm not one of those people. Though, from other people that I've seen, I think the Green Karazim quest is very good if you're planning to play 1v1 Karazim on solo lane. So, yeah. Oh, why is Ragnaros telling me to go solo lane? No, I went Test for Blood, and I'm gonna stack very fast and very nice with our Johanna here. Johanna is the best tank to stack as an Asmodan Taste for Blood, if you're planning to play that. And this is one of his best maps as well, because the rotation on the Tomb of the Sparkwing is such an easy to rotate that you can just clear and safely rotate to the other side. Now, I had times where the enemy team would actually get on the right side here, right side of the objective, and block our rotational path and just kill us. But as you can see at the moment, this is not happening. They're just trying to follow our rotations and just wave clear themselves. Which is not ideal to deal with Taste for Blood Asmodan, but maybe they don't know, maybe they haven't played this matchup that often to know exactly how to deal with it. Now, I'm noticing that we're actually missing some stacks here. We've been rotating very nicely, but we're missing some stacks because we've been missing the range minions, and mostly because Gul'dan has been not able to throw one of his Qs just to help us out. But he's going to be able to do on that last wave, as you saw. And that's just it. Like, I can do the stacking mainly with only Johanna, but having a Gul'dan also helps out quite a lot to do it even faster. Now, this is going to be a very repetitive game moving forward from this point, because our goal is to do the same thing, to wave clear, to get the golden, the Asmodan stacks, and to not die. Now, what the enemy team can do in this situation is pressure us for gems, which hopefully they will do, or pressure us for a team fight if we're out of position, like they're trying to do at the moment. But generally, we're pretty beefy picks. They cannot really take me out as an Asmodan. And Johanna is a pretty good zoning tank. So, you can see how Asmodan Johanna works pretty well. Not only with zoning, but with clearing fast the waves. Another thing that their team can do to counter us is to put heavy pressure on the bottom lane. And as we can see, Liming has traveled to the bottom lane, but it seems like a Ragnaros Bestial Monster has been able to easily deal with Mautel, so we're going to be dominating all lanes. Now, I'm already 90 stacks on 3 minutes, and that is, I'm gonna tell you guys, that is insane. Usually I actually wrote it. Usually I get with a uncoordinated team, 100 stacks till around level 10. And I'm at that point on level 6, 3 minutes in. So you can imagine how much power I'm going to have once I reach level 10. And that is because my team was so well coordinated in the draft and so willing to help me out. I didn't hear what he saw. Maybe someone pinged Karazim to deliver James and he was like, yeah, chill guys. Enemy did deliver spiders, alright. They're making a right move to try to stop us from what we're doing. Excellent. Now, as an Asmodan, my wave clear is pretty well without Blackpool on level 10, so I'm very reliant on Johanna and on Gul'dan as well, early. I'm gonna have enough wave clear to just remove the entire lane myself on level 10, but until then, I cannot do any of that. I really need the backup damage from our teammates. And already I'm almost 150 stacks, so Ragnaros did that on the bottom, so I'm just gonna soak. When this situation happens, when they deliver the first spiders, you just want to spread all three on the three lanes and just soak it. Their team can't really put that much pressure. I almost did damage the Mautel there, but yeah, I'm actually getting very aggressively pushed here. Mautel again coming. I actually missed my Q on him, but I was planning to just clear the wave there. I'm asking for some help, but yeah, they don't really have that much damage early on. I could have also sent a Q there to try to damage the Mautel, but I'm just really focused on just mainly getting stacks here on the minions. Is Johanna gonna die there? We still have the Ragnaros. I'm gonna throw a Q on the Malfurion. Is Ragnaros? No, he's going to get out. And I might die actually here, but Mautel going extremely well. He's afraid to fall that deep. I'm looking for a Q on the Mautel. Oh, is he going to die from the poison? And that is going to be 10 points. Now, if you didn't know how Taste for Blood works, if you kill an enemy hero or or 1.5 seconds after you hit him with your Q, you get 10 points of damage towards your red quest. While minions give only 2, I believe. Yeah, it was 2. So a hero, you sniping a hero is not as good. Sniping a hero Q is not as good as securing one minion wave of Q quest stacking, but you do get bonus experience from killing the hero, and then the wave. Oh, I missed the Q on the Mautel there. And you just remove some pressure because he's a dead teammate. So we're going to come on level 10 with 170 stacks, and as you can see, with 170 stacks, I am able to one-shot the ranged minions on a wave. And around like 200-250, I think I can clear the entire wave with the melee minions as well. So I'm just going to be coming into my late game very early on, like 7 minutes in. Usually I get to this point in around like 10-12 minutes. So my team made me escalate my Asmodan power just so nicely. I'm just gonna dunk on that Malfurion for extra 10 points. And yeah, he was asking about the cocoon. Oh, this is very strange fighting there. I think we should back. I'm just gonna throw my bow on the wave. The enemy is just soaking all of the damage as well, which is perfect. And I'm gonna back, probably recall, because I'm out of mana. Now, the talents. I forgot to talk about the talents. You go for Q talents. Taste for Blood 7 is going to be Inferno. Go for the speed so you can snipe more accurately. And on level 4, I just go Army of Hell. Just so I can spam minions for vision on lower mana cost. One thing you can do is actually, one trick I can give you on Asmodan is you can send your W, your small minion through walls to reveal to reveal positions, which is very neat because the minion has like a summoning distance from your point. Oh, nice spawn there. I'm gonna try to send a Q into the Oppo here, but our team is just going to be in a very bad spot. I'm gonna get cocooned, and it seems that the enemy team is actually gaining a lot of value. I'm probably gonna die here, cocoon ring down, but I'm gonna get rooted, and it seems like I'm just gonna get executed on the spot. Yeah. It seems Ragnaros got caught, and they just followed up on a Q on the cocoon. And in this situation, their team should decide to, yeah, spiders, that's fine. We're actually securing the mercenary camp, so that's pretty cool. Now, on level 13, you should go, most of the times, I go, oh, our teammates are actually gonna get, yeah, the problem there was that, Druhana and Karazim didn't have enough damage, so they took too much time to clear the mercenary camp, and they just got invaded and we lost everything. So I'm just gonna stay on the top. We have Ragnaros on the middle, so he's gonna clear a lot of them. I just wanna clear the top one, so I can then join my team. Now, I could potentially leave the spider, but things might get very invaded and we might lose the fort. And I just hope my teammates just play it safe. Why did Ragnaros say GG? Beats me, I wasn't there, I didn't work. So I most of the time, me personally, I go, oh, I see a Walmart there. Can I snap him? Bam. Into the Druhana, double snipe for 20 points there. Oh, such sweet value. And that was thanks to the Druhana pulling them back to her. I go Hedoism because I like to be healthy on mana. This is just personal choice. It's actually probably not the ideal choice for this talent slot. Most of the times I would suggest you to go for the minion upgrade, which gives your minion pulsing fire damage and reduce damage taken by 50% by non-heroic enemies, which allows your army of hell minion to be more durable in pushing, and just being able to do the pulsing damage allows you to, let's say, reveal Zagara tumors or reveal standard heroes, which is pretty valuable. But generally, on this map, for instance, I just like to be able to have the mana to not back and just keep pressuring the lanes with the 60 to 30 mana cost reduction. But most of the times, as I said, the level 13 on the minion is the better choice to upgrade. I'm going to try to just clear the mercenary camp. We're going to get the spiders. Oh, arrow going to the Gul'dan. We're taking a lot of damage. Karazim into cocoon. We're trying to help him out. Very well open on the cocoon. I'm going to try to just send my bow into the wave, but Mofirin's going to get out of position. Very nice stasis, by the way, dodging the Ragnaros smash there. So Sulfura smash, but he's going to die eventually because he was heavily out of position. Now Ragnaros doing a lot of damage. I'm going to throw one Q on the Mautel. Can Ragnaros change his switch on the Mautel? He doesn't see the Mautel. He's just keep pressuring on the Liming. But yeah, I'm just going to try to keep moving forward, getting vision, so maybe I can snipe low Liming there. But I decided to get the stacks from my minion wave. 300 stacks, 11 minutes. That's insane, insane speed on the stacking. This is probably one of the games that I have stacked the fastest ever. I don't remember being able to stack so good, because not only that we had good stacking buddies, Druhana and Gul'dan, but the enemy team couldn't have really stopped us early on from that stacking. Ragnaros now in a very bad spot. I'm gonna throw a Q there, but yeah, Druhana's gonna get cocoon, and Ragnaros should have stick with us on the bottom there. I think that was a cocky mistake from him to go sock on the middle. I could have just de-pushed the middle with Asmodan. We just need to seek as a 5-man and maybe secure the keep, the bottom keep. So that was a bit of a cocky mistake from Ragnaros. I just hope that this doesn't cost us like the boss. They don't seem to be going for the boss. Mato is very close to the siege camp here, so Karazim might be in trouble. He's trying to sneak it around with the vision he is gaining from his Q, but Hanzo coming in. Is Karazim going to overstay? No, he's going to get contested and he should just back off here. He's trying to back off Druhana ulting. Oh, now if Cocoon happens here, we're gonna get screwed. Nice block on the Hanzo arrow there. I'm gonna miss my entire Q. Fear for more disengage, and we're in a very shit spot. We just don't wanna fight here. Ragnaros not coming, but we're extremely low. A noob coming in. It's Cocoon gonna happen. I'm gonna throw a Q there. Limming blinked in just in my Q there. So Furious Smash missing. And oh, Ragnaros going extremely low. Palm being used and missing. And I think it's just a good spot here to just back away. Not a good place to fight. I'm gonna land a pretty good Q there. But Mati ultimate securing another Q. Another Q for the enemy team. And this is just going to be a throw from our team. A big throw. I really didn't like how my team played this out, because there was at least 3 points in that team fight that our team should have just dead serious left out of there, because a lot of stuff were missed. We were pretty well the entire time, and you just don't overstay. You just need to have the instinct to know where to, when to back. And as an Asmodan, my damage is just from my Q, so a good time to turn would be when I land a good power of damage, but that wasn't the case. Their team was pushing us on a pretty big HP situation, so yeah. We're gonna secure the mercenary camp here. I'm gonna push the bottom, and we're just going to be trying to defend the boss. Coming up to the 400 stack mark, I'm pretty fed as an Asmodan. I just need my team to play it more patiently and more coordinated. Meaning that we should stick as 5 and we shouldn't be overextending when we cannot. So their team is actually gonna decide to depush the lanes and secure spiders instead of pushing with the boss, which is, in my opinion, not a good choice. They should have just delivered the gems after the boss and just went hard pushing, because in like that they just give us time to remove a lot of the threats on the map till they themselves coordinate group up. On level 16 I went Battleborn. This means that when I land the Q on at least one enemy hero, Army of Hell minion is gonna spawn. It's not that much, but generally the Army of Hell, the W minion, is very good just to block limiting missiles, to be honest. If one of my minions can block like a Limming W, it's very valuable for us. You can also block some of the Hanzo arrows and stuff, so it's pretty good versus range teams. We're taking a lot of damage on the Johanna. I'm trying to... Hanzo arrow coming in. We have extremely low people here. We should just play very passive here, because Ragnaros is on the top. And yeah. I just used an Untalented Q there, because my black pool is on cooldown. I see a very wall limit there. Can I secure? Yeah, that is going to be insane damage, like 1k plus, because I just have so many stacks. Just executing a half HP limit there, and that is going to give the motivation on our team to push them in. I'm also max stacks. Like, it's very rare for me to be able to get max stacks till level 20. I'm probably not gonna get it on the level 20 mark, but it's very rare. Usually I get it around level 22, 23 on a slow Asmodan game, but this time it has been going excellent to us. Yes, we can pay James. I'm actually missing 3. Anub going very deep here. Very deep in my opinion on the Anub. He doesn't have escape, and we're just gonna snipe him in. So Furious Smash wasted, but it's on a pretty low cooldown, so that's gonna be fine. And now we're gonna have enough gems. They have 2 people dead, so this looks like an opportunity for us to close the game. Gonna depush the bottom, siege cam on the bottom, mercenary on the middle, and we have a lot of good opportunities. We're gonna have the level 20, we have the dead timer, and this is the perfect situation for us to stack as a team and push. Now, I actually really wanted on the bottom. I'm gonna go for recruitment as well, so we put more pressure on the map. But the right choice is actually to push on the middle, because the mercenary camp itself gives us magic resistance. I just want to, in the meantime, I just want to be able to pressure the bottom as well with the siege camp to make Hanzo be a bit more cautious, to not overextend, to kill the siege camps, and we are going to secure just like that 2 keeps. Mouth is gonna get filled with the minus 25 armor, but we won't be able to do anything there. I'm gonna snipe for some damage, but generally they're pushing us pretty hard here, and seems like a good time to disengage. Wait, we actually didn't secure the spiders. What? I thought that the spiders were secured. Well, to be honest now, their team is pushing for a fight. Yeah, don't fight, guys. This is actually better for us because we actually managed to secure two keeps without the spiders, and now we can pressure them for the third keep, which is excellent. It's gonna be excellent value for us. And it makes some sense because we did have one dead on the dead timer, so we could have forced fight 4v5. But now Karazim is gonna get cocooned. Ragnar's out of position. Godan's stunned. Ragnar seems he's gonna die. I'm trying to deal some damage, and now we're all of a sudden 4v5. We do have the pushing power, but if I don't land a good Q, maybe on the Liming there, if we don't land the Q, bam on the Liming, not enough there. If we had a Karazim to follow up, that would have been great. But my Q is coming up in 3 seconds. Can I land a good snipe on the Liming there? I see her. Can I land the snipe? Come on, Blackpool. Blackpool is not on, is out of cooldown. That's why I'm not throwing the Q. An un-Blackpool Q probably wouldn't have been enough for the Liming. But as my teammates are pushing on the top, I'm looking here to maybe remove some of the middle minions that are going to spawn. But I'm just going to turn back to the top. Liming is gonna eat one of the Qs, but she had the magic armor this time around. I don't get why all of you want to defend. No, we didn't want to defend. We actually wanted to push with the spider itself. And you were just your front face and died. Oh, yes. Liming actually breaking exactly into my Q. Okay. So we're 4v5, we can actually pressure the boss here. And I'm going to finish my quest on level 21. A bit later, but still 500 max quest in 90 minutes is still pretty good time. Most of the times I do it like 25 minutes or something. So we're gonna pressure the boss. Their last chance here is to probably defend. A smart team would leave the boss and defend on keep. But they might decide to go greedy. 4v5, which is also an option. They could potentially do it. It's not impossible. It really depends how well they're gonna play it out. Gul'dan Fear, gonna throw the Q on the mouth and execute him. And yeah, just the Gul'dan Fear allowing me to land a good snipe. A noob going deep. But oh, Ragnaros Smash missing because of the stun. Palm missing. But Hanzo gonna get in a bad position. And now with them having two teammates dead, we're just going to be able to run over them with the boss, with the other waves, and I don't think they can do anything about it. They do have a Lim Ming, but
Osmo, which minute your full stacks? I don't see.
Full stacks what? I didn't understand him. He doesn't see full stacks or something, I don't know. I think he asked me when I completed full stacks, which was 19 minutes. But yeah. This, ladies and gentlemen, is going to be tasteful, but Asmodan, I wouldn't suggest you to pick it that often because you really want to have very precise team compositional picks to make it work properly and to escalate it early on. So it's a very situational pick that you can keep in mind on maps like Tomb of the Spider Queen to give you some pretty cool value. Yeah, I think he asked me that. I told him 18. But it was in reality 19. So that's going to be everything from me from today, guys. Asmodan over my endgame. Thank you for watching. And until next time, stay righteous.